Don't take Viagra if you have heart problems. It's dangerous to your health, right? No, wrong. What if I told you the opposite might be true? So could a pill that makes you harder also make you live longer? This is exactly what I will explain to you in this video. And no, I'm not paid by Big Pharma and I'm not receiving any money or benefits from any company for making this video. We have pretty strict laws against that in Europe, you know? For doctors, that is. Everybody else may advertise as they please. Too bad I'm a doctor. Stefan Buntrock, board-certified urologist with a focus on men's health and longevity. My mission is simple, empowering men to live 10 years longer. Today we look at PDE5 inhibitors, medicines like sildenafil, tadalafil, and vardenafil with a clear lens. The claim is not that a sex pill is a magic anti-aging drug. We'll get to longevity after a short introduction. And if you watch the video until the end, there will be a bonus tip of how these drugs prevent Alzheimer's disease. So don't forget to do that. First, let's deal with the danger question. For decades, people believed these drugs were bad for the heart. The truth, the only real danger is taking them together with nitrates, because that combination can drop your blood pressure to dangerous levels. But if you are not on nitrates, the data actually suggests the opposite. Protection, not risk. It's not proven 100%, but we're getting close. Let's look at the evidence. The AUS registry study at the University of Texas tracked over 70,000 men with erectile dysfunction. Those taking tadalafil had a 34% lower risk of death from any cause compared to men who didn't. 1 in 3 lives saved. That is not a small effect. Another study from Sweden followed men who had already survived a heart attack. Those prescribed PDE5 inhibitors not only lived longer, but also had fewer repeat cardiac events. Think about that. Men with damaged hearts were actually protected. Mechanistically, this makes sense. PDE5 inhibitors amplify nitric oxide cGMP signaling. That pathway relaxes vessel walls, improves endothelial function, and reduces arterial stiffness. In plain language, better circulation everywhere. And remember, the penis is the antenna of the heart. Penile arteries are the first to show vascular disease, often 5 to 7 years before a heart attack. When you fix erectile function, you are often fixing the same biology that keeps the heart safe. The practical question is not, does a blue pill add years, but rather, does targeted treatment of erectile dysfunction alongside risk factor control align with patterns of better survival and function? The evidence we do have suggests an association worth discussing with nuance. Favorable observational signals across heart and brain outcomes, mechanistic plausibility in vascular biology, and clear boundaries about risks and indications. That is the frame for today's analysis. Now to specifics. In a large US cohort of men with erectile dysfunction, sustained use of tadalafil was associated with lower all-cause mortality over follow-up compared with non-use, and cardiovascular outcomes tracked in the same favorable direction. Scandinavian registry analyses in men with prior myocardial infarction found that those receiving PDE5 inhibitors lived longer and had fewer recurrent events than men receiving alternative therapies after adjustment strategies such as propensity score methods. These are associations, not proofs, yet the direction is consistent across data sets. Men treated with PDE5 inhibitors appear to have better survival and fewer major adverse cardiac events. The physiology fits. PDE5 inhibition amplifies the nitric oxide cGMP pathway, improving endothelial function and microvascular recruitment, which matters in territories with tiny vessels that fail early, like the penis and parts of the myocardium. How many years can you gain? I'm sorry, it would be unprofessional to put a number on that. It depends a lot on the individual circumstances, but I think it is safe to say that it's probably more than a few days. Hopefully, we'll get more precise data in the future. So before you rush to the pharmacy, please remember, this video is not medical advice. You must speak to your doctor first before you start on drugs like that. There may be personal circumstances in your health that prohibit such medication. We need crisp boundaries. These medicines are not lifestyle supplements, and they are absolutely contraindicated with nitrates because the combination can produce dangerous hypotension. They interact with certain alpha blockers and other drugs, and dosing should be individualized, especially in men with significant cardiac disease or impaired renal or hepatic function. Registry signals cannot replace randomized long-term trials, and healthier user bias may inflate benefits if men who seek treatment also engage in better overall care. That is why the right message is balance: promising data, plausible mechanisms, real-world usefulness for erectile symptoms, paired with medical evaluation and risk control. Practical guidance helps. If a man has erectile symptoms and no nitrate therapy, a discussion with his physician about a trial of a PDE5 inhibitor can be reasonable, alongside aggressive management of sleep apnea, weight, blood pressure, glucose, and lipids. Monitor response, adverse effects, and blood pressure. Avoid recreational stacking with alcohol or unknown supplements. If symptoms begin abruptly or come with chest pain, dyspnea, or new exercise intolerance, prioritize cardiac evaluation first. The vision is straightforward. Sexual health is a systems check. When you protect endothelial function, improve fitness, sleep more consistently, and treat apnea, you often protect erections, and the same habits protect the heart and brain. Speaking of the brain, I promised you a bonus. Alzheimer's disease is linked to a limited blood flow in the brain. If you increase that, theoretically, it could keep away that terrible condition. So here's the good news. A 2021 analysis in Nature Aging looked at insurance records of more than 7 million people. Men taking sildenafil had a 69% reduced risk of Alzheimer's disease. 69%! PDE5 inhibitors can cross into brain tissue, increase cGMP, and improve cerebral blood flow. They also reduce neuroinflammation and may even help clear amyloid plaques, those toxic proteins that drive Alzheimer's. Animal studies confirm better memory formation under these drugs. This is not proof, but the signal is strong enough that major trials are underway. Here's a German saying, "Der Mensch ist, was ist." Doesn't sound as witty in English. Man becomes what he eats. It's a reminder that everything counts. I'm not talking about pills, I'm talking about nutrition. Is there anything you can eat to protect your penis and boost erections? If this is your burning question, then this playlist is a must watch. I'll try to link you a newsletter in the description. Still struggling with technique? Let me know if it doesn't work. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.